You guys ready for your next act? Because he's another awesome book. You're gonna love the dude. He's hilarious. Put your hands together. Put your heads together for Ron Sparks.
Hi, everybody. I'm Ron. I'm pretty creepy. But I can also be quite hilarious, so we'll just see which one of me shows up tonight. My set this evening is being brought to you by Coffee Time. Coffee Time! We're just like Tim Hortons, only somebody probably died here. I didn't tell a joke just then, but guess I even walk funny, huh? It was great to be back. I've been sitting in Canada in like a month and a half. But I'm excited to spend the rest of 2013 here. It's going to be fun. That's a year. I was worried it was in the past or something. All right, I'm back. Thanks, Doc. The DeLorean did the trick. No, it's great to be here for 2013 because I know in 2013 there will be no Euro Cup or World Cup. And soccer fans in this country are retarded. Are there any soccer fans here tonight? See what I mean? I just said you were retards and you still identify yourself. A bunch of idiots. Nothing personal, but you're retarded idiots. Here's the thing, I have a right to be angry. What is it in your brain that says, what? Portugal just won an exciting 1-0 barn burner after only 80 minutes of extra time. And it's 4 a.m. I better drive around and honk and scream a lot. Wake up, everybody! Honk, honk, honk! Hey, has Portugal won? And I'm pretty sure Grandpa's from there. Screaming for countries you've never been to. Portugal! Hey, let's drive around Ron's house some more. I want to make sure he's up. Ron, Portugal won. It's the most exciting news ever because we love Portugal. Unless Portugal's been eliminated, then we magically become Brazilian. Hooray, Portugal / Brazil. Oh, I hate you all. The little laughing fool you. There's nothing but rage. It's not too bad though, because I figured I got a plan for revenge. I don't want to, it's a great plan, you're going to like it. Here's what I'm going to do, is next time Canada is in some hockey tournament nobody over there cares about, I am flying to Lisbon. I am renting a car, and I'm going to drive around and honk and scream my head off. We're wake up, everybody! We have the most exciting news! Because Canada's under 18. Women's team. You guys in Portugal, you should be more excited about this because hockey is just like soccer, only it doesn't suck. Nobody ever drinks shirts, which is weird. So my next joke is brought to you by the cashier I had last night at Sobeys. Do your groceries come with enough, bitch? United States. Hey, you know what store has a stupid name? Blinds to Go. Why did they have to add the to go? They used to have a big problem where people would walk into the store. I would like some blinds for here, please. How it works is I'm going to pay you for the blinds, and then you help me hang them in your own store. Because I'm tired of driving by this naked window to Iceland. Why haven't you put any of these up? Your store's full of them. What, no faith in your own product? Why is it? What's that? Go back to sports for a minute? Okay. I don't know if you heard the latest Lance Armstrong news just today that came out, but even though he has been banned from cycling, and Lance Armstrong had all of his records and titles stripped by the U.S. Anti-Doping Agency, but Lance Armstrong has announced he is still going to come back and compete in the Tour de France one last time. Man, that takes ball. It's a bit of a math joke, I guess. Which brings me to Hitler. As the town near the village where Hitler was born recently voted to revoke his honorary citizenship. I bet now he's sorry. Well, you can just full on make out and get it over with. It's hard to tell jokes when this turned on. Oh, don't assume it's her. It's that Dukes of Hazzard shirt. I just want to jump in my car's window and drive home. I see you, light. I'd just like to say that I've come to a decision recently. I've decided that animal hospitals should not be allowed to hire hot women to work at their reception desks. I've decided this because there's an animal hospital on my street, and every morning I cannot walk by without looking in the window and thinking, oh man, I have got to hurt my cat. No, ma'am, I have no idea how she managed to tie four knots in her own tail. But I bet we could get to the bottom of this mystery over dinner. Please don't turn me down, or I'll just come back again tomorrow. Because my dog is clumsy. Anyway, I wish I could stand here all night. You guys are great.